tonight on the Xtra Factor The Aftermath.
The show is not about Simon and Ashley, it's about the X Factor.
The one thing I have to say, you've got a smaller TV.
Welcome to Liverpool, and today we're going to show you around.
I've never seen Simon this upset.
Hi, guys. What are you guys doing on Tuesday?
Oh, I will be back to the normal rubs in a couple of days, you know what I mean?
Every Saturday night, they sing live for your votes. The 16 to 24-year-olds, under the wing of the ever-youthful record supremo, Simon Cowell. The 25s and over, managed by no-nonsense rock manager Sharon Osbourne. And the groups, led by Ireland's very own pop Svengali, Louis Walsh. Every week, the Xtra Factor, The Aftermath, is your chance to catch the fallout from Saturday. Our cameras will take you where no one else is allowed to go, bringing you exclusive access to the losing act, revealing what goes on inside the X Factor house, taking you to the top secret rehearsals, and much, much more in the life of an X Factor finalist. This is The Aftermath. Week four in the studio, and only eight acts are left, all of them singing to survive into next week. But there's also a battlefield on the judges' table. Louis and Sharon are down to just two acts each, but Simon still has all four of his acts left. The theme is the notoriously difficult songs from ABBA, and being watched over by ABBA's very own Björn Ulvaeus would put each and every contestant under additional scrutiny. But that would prove to be nothing when faced with the X Factor judges. Not one was in forgiving mood.
I think you're a one-trick pony.
Hated it.
Big time problems tonight.
And not one was afraid to express themselves.
The sort of thing you would hear at a mediocre wedding.
Now is the time to be blatantly honest.
Simon gave you the wrong song again.
Again.
The worst guitar solo I have ever heard in my life.
You have to get better to stay in the competition.
It was a disservice from your mentor. The song is not good for you.
Even those who'd done well in previous shows didn't come up to scratch for ABBA Week.
Ray, the show is called The X Factor. It's not called The Swing Factor.
I thought the whole thing was a bit desperate, to be honest.
And, as always, it was the public who decided. And Ashley and Robert were in the bottom two. After singing again, it was left to Louis to make the decision.
And Louis, you've got to keep Ashley in.
Kate, the act I'm sending home tonight is Ashley.
So, Ashley is leaving the X Factor for good. But for Simon, Louis' decision was wrong and he made his feelings quite clear.
You know, I think that, Louis, you were very spiteful with what you just did.
What? Simon, you're such a bad loser.
And for Louis, the decision was clear-cut.
I saved Ashley last week. And the show is not about Simon and Ashley, it's about the X Factor. I kept Robert because I know he's got a lot more to give.
And so Mr. Cow loses one of his four acts, but he was not at all happy. So unhappy, in fact, that he refused to join me on the couch after the show.
Is he not coming up?
Apparently he's not coming up, though.
Why?
He's too upset.
And he took refuge in his dressing room and refused to come out.
He's having a bad hair day. He's not talking to me, but I don't care. I honestly really couldn't care less.
I've never seen Simon this upset. In the 3 years we've been doing the show, I've never seen a look on his face like I saw tonight.
Not even the persuasive Mrs. O could coax him out.
I'm not in the mood, Sharon.
He's being such a diva. I'm like, we're all passionate. We all want our artist to stay. And Simon just has to respect somebody else's decision and opinion. Obviously, I am really happy about tonight's result because Robert has got another chance. But, you know, every week somebody has to go. And no matter how hard we work our artist, it's up to the public.
But backstage, there seemed to be others who agreed with Louis.
He virtually saved Ashley the week before, but said, you better step up your game. And I think that Louis thought that he didn't, and so he voted his conscience.
Louis did make the right decision purely because I have got a big soft spot for Robert. I think he's amazing. I think he's very passionate. You just kind of warm to him.
I have to say Robert did out-sing Ashley both times tonight, and it wouldn't be fair for Louis to have saved Ashley 2 weeks in a row. And this week, Robert was the better man.
With Simon refusing to comment, Sunita explained just how much Simon feels he's lost in one night.
Ashley was one of our champions, you know. I mean, Simon described him as a racehorse 1 week, and that's really how we saw him. We thought we had this baby racehorse that was gonna win the race for us, actually, so it's a bit shocking. But, you know, it wasn't his best performance, was it?
But Ashley feels his problems began before tonight.
Last week for me was really, really tough. Obviously, where I forgot my lyrics and whatever. So going in this week and having to perform, that was just playing on my brain, playing, playing, playing. That's all I could see really in front of me. The pressure is just on you, like, bang.
If Ashley had gone last week, I'd have thought, well, maybe Amy made a mistake. But this week, another mistake has been made, and Ashley never made it. Louis made it.
He definitely has the X factor. It's just a matter of, vocally, it didn't match what some of the other contestants were doing.
I don't think people actually realise how much pressure and how much hard work is put into being on the show. And everyone down there, they are just super strong because it takes some serious guts and confidence.
But despite leaving the X Factor, he remains philosophical.
I've made some wicked friends, I've gained a great experience. Everybody wants to see their name in bright lights and everybody wants to shine, and that's what I've achieved, you know what I'm saying? I've had my name in bright lights, so I'm really blessed, very, very happy.
He was so gracious in losing. You know, that really says something about him as a human being.
I think that Ashley is a star. And I just feel that tonight he was under pressure, and I was so sorry that he went.
You seem all right.
Yeah,
I'm more upset
man.
Than you.
I know, everyone's more upset than me.
I'm devastated, and you're like, oh, Evie, I'm okay.
I'm fine, I'm good.
For Robert, tonight was the second time he's been in the bottom two, and getting through to next week at the expense of a friend hit him hard.
Robert, seriously, I can't do it. Seriously, please. Thank you. I'm really happy that I've got through, you know what I mean? But I led up with my friend, you know what I'm saying to you? And you know what I mean? To having to... having to just go up against, you know what I mean? Like, my friend and then, you know what I mean, get chosen. It's just... I'm just upset, man.
He feels an alliance to everyone that's in the house. How awkward can it be, you know, when you're friends with someone and you're stood up there and which one's going to stay, which one's going to go?
I guarantee this time, you know what I mean, I can't do it again. I'm not going to be in the bottom two again. I'd rather go home and record my album and just build my way up from there, because this competition is just too much heartache. It's too much heartache.
Tomorrow morning, we're in a studio picking the next song, getting the arrangement, getting it ready to go. So Robert's going to have to not let his heart get in the way of his talent.
So as everyone prepares to head home, Ashley has to gather his belongings for the last time.
To lose someone out of your category is... oh, it's like losing a friend. The competition is not going to be the same. And the house is not going to be the same. We're just going to miss him to bits, to be honest.
And then finally, the Aftermath team caught up with the man himself.
Wrong result. Louis Walsh was spiteful. So maybe we'll deal with Louis next week.
Simon thinks it's his world and we're all lucky to be breathing his air. You know, he's not right all the time, you know, and he's not going to win this competition this year.
But before everyone leaves the studio, Mrs. O has a special announcement.
Hi.
Hey. How are you? Doing on Tuesday?
Simon, what's going on?
I need a date because.
I'll come with you. You're the one that always dances in a room.
I know, I'll
come with you. Yes, for you, Sharon. I won't have your meanings.
So, sweet. It's just that Andy Abraham, my lovely Andy, is performing at the Royal Albert Hall on Tuesday, and I don't want to go on my own.
Can we all come?
And we'll all go and we'll party.
Yeah.
We'll meet him afterwards and we'll all have a great night out, right?
Yeah.
Stephanie?
Yeah.
Mama doesn't have to go on her own.
No.
Thank you.
After another live show finishes, the X Factor contestants arrive back at the house.
Home again. For another week, maybe.
Bye.
Ooh. Hi.
Good night.
For some contestants, the excitement of the week has all been too much, and they hit the hay. Some of the other housemates take this opportunity to let off a bit of steam and give Ashley a proper send-off.
This is to a bright future, a great past, and great friends.
For what will be Ashley's last Saturday night in the house, the 16 to 24s have one final bonding session. It's just another average Saturday night in the X Factor house. Coming up.
He has more problems than that, is the fact that his voice is so rough.
Because I was that close from having the £1 million record deal, you see what I'm saying?
We're gonna go right in this room!
If we come into this competition as solo artists, I don't think we would have got here.
Sometimes it's very straightforward, and today has not been straightforward at all.
Is this yours?
Yeah!
Nokia, music gets you talking.
Oh, I wonder what's in there. Secret things, like suppositories.
Hi guys, just thought I'd share some thoughts about last Saturday. It was amazing just going out onto the stage and performing. You know, it was just so many emotions, you know, happy 1 minute and just like petrified the next. I got some really nice comments, one especially from Louis Walsh. He said that I could be the first female to win the X Factor, and that was just, oh, that was amazing. It just gives me the drive to keep on pushing myself, work hard and try and do better and better each week.
Sunday morning, and it can mean only one thing.
Start our way to the studio to find out what we're singing for next week. The anticipation's becoming even more intense now, isn't it?
News just in. It's love song week. Dun, dun,
dun. First up, it's the McDonald's, who've already got their concerns.
Thing is, the love theme could be another slow song. So
I'm getting used to the slow songs now. Louis knows what he's talking about. He just knows, like, that's one thing really good about him. He knows his songs, and he's picking them right all the time. But what he said is he's come up with a few ideas.
Ben, meanwhile, doesn't seem to have a care in the world.
I'm much happier with this week's theme, definitely. SOS was actually the only ABBA song that I could have got away with, so I was very lucky that they wrote that. And this week, there's just like loads to choose from, so hopefully we can get the perfect song.
And our boys from Liverpool couldn't be happier.
We've just heard our song for the very first time, With Love From Me To You. By the Beatles. Louis chosen for us. It's absolutely fantastic. I'm really, really chuffed with it this week, definitely.
Four lads from Liverpool. We're four lads from Liverpool as well. I think it's going to go down really well.
What's your initial thoughts today?
Yeah, like it?
It's amazing. I look at Nigel.
Great! This is too easy. Something's got to go wrong.
What's wrong?
So Eton Road are in the zone, as is Ben with his rock ballad Don't Want to Miss a Thing.
You've got to make sure that you pull on that.
Little, you know, there's some high notes in it, there's some really high notes in it, but I think if I can just pull them off, then the song is going to be excellent. I'm really looking forward to it.
This is a thing that gets confusing, because everyone says, you know, is it too predictable that Ben is doing a rock song because he's a rocker? He has more problems than that, is the fact that his voice is so rough that he sings so hard that sometimes it gets tender and he can't make those notes.
Rest of time, keep you satisfied, keep you satisfied.
It is a really good Beatles song, we're just going to try and put our own eating mode, sort of.
What you need to remember though as well, the Beatles do really well, like the most successful band ever. You can't do the Beatles, no one can do the Beatles.
But something tells me routining today isn't all going to go this well. While the others are rehearsing, on the other side of town, the story for the losing contestant is very different. Ashley is preparing to leave the house. But the early start is too much for Ashley's roommate Ray to deal with, so he slips out to get some extra shut-eye.
Obviously the whole X-Factor journey is over for me now, but it's been a great experience. Being here has been like a proper emotional roller coaster. It's just up and down, round and round. I've had some really great times, like really, really great times, and some really down times. So I'm really going to miss Nikki, R, Ray, Leona, Robert. I think Louis definitely contradicted himself. Obviously, on the one hand, he said how I'm great, I've got star quality, I look good, I sound good, I'm missing that all positivity, but I'm sending you home, which doesn't make any sense whatsoever. This has made me stronger, and it's made me believe that if I want, I can go get it, because I was that close from having the £1 million record deal, you see what I'm saying? So anything's possible, anything is possible.
Ashley is off for the weekly X Factor press conference.
I can't believe all those months ago, I went to Bristol to audition. Didn't think I would get here at all, and it's just ended. I am a strong person, but at the end of the day, I'm only human still. And I just want to cry, but I'm not going to let myself cry because, like I said, I gained a great experience.
Before the press conference begins, the X Factor press officer briefs him on this morning's big story.
I think the big story is going to be the feud between Louis and Simon. So just to warn you, that's mainly, I think, what they'll be asking you about.
Okay.
Simon obviously accused Louis of being spiteful by getting you out. Mm. So they will ask you what you think about that.
Obviously, you're out. Disappointment. Yeah. Do you think it's Louis got rid of you because you are toughest competition, maybe out of you and Robert, you know, stiffest competition, biggest rival to his act?
I wouldn't say I'm the biggest rival to his acts at all, but I think Simon's team, like me, Leona, Nikita and Ray as a whole, I think we had the strongest going for us when we were young, we was fresh.
Yeah, do you think Louis was being spiteful?
I wouldn't say he was being spiteful. I think he was just in it to win, so.
Ashley, what was your personal highlight in the show?
Waking up every day in that house, knowing that I'm going to get up, go to routining, go to rehearsals, sound check, that's just been a buzz, you see what I'm saying? And when them doors open and the crowd warm to you, it's just like, it's just surreal.
Where do you see yourself in the future?
I want to be respected for putting a good message out to the world. As a great artist like Lionel Richie, Tony Bennett, Rod Stewart, all them great ones that come down, I just want to be known in like 20 years' time to come. People going sick for me in the audience, like Ashley McKenzie, and like, just having that reputation, having that career, and just becoming a great, great artist.
After a close call on last night's show, Robert takes the time out to watch his performance.
I remembered all my words. That's the main thing.
OK, guys, the two of you will compete head-to-head in tonight's final showdown.
Last night, I was in the bottom two, and, you know what I mean, that really did knock my confidence because it is so intense. It's such an emotional roller coaster. It's almost like the big dip at Brighton, you know what I mean? And I'm just hanging now, like, you know, when you get up to the top, that's gone now, you know what I mean? I'm just spiralling and it ain't even stopping, you know what I mean? It's not stopping.
Robert, you've been here before. Can you pull it back again?
You keep reminding yourself that it's a competition, but if you've got a heart as big as mine, yeah, it doesn't matter if it's a competition, you know what I mean? You just get so emotional.
Okay, guys, well done to you both. I know that's not easy.
I didn't like competing against my friend, you know what I mean? And I know it's not about friends and you've got to think about yourself and all of this kind of thing, but that's not me at the end of the day. I'm the kind of person that, you know what I mean? I'd have preferred it if... I will be back to the normal rubs in a couple of days, you know what I mean? But right now, I'm just still getting over that, you know what I mean? That myself, you know what I mean? And my good friend was in the bottom two. And, you know, it had to be only two, you know what I mean? We're all great, talented vocalists in the house. Don't get me wrong, and we're all here because we all want to win it.
Back at the studios, the McDonald's have been given a choice of two songs by Louis, but have yet to decide which one to try out. Meanwhile, next door, Leona is hard at work routining Christina Aguilera's Beautiful, but then a call comes in from Simon.
I think Simon's having a rethink, so we're going to have to wait and see what he says.
There's some talk of it being the other Beautiful.
Oh, so we're thinking James Blunt?
But while Leona was right at home with Christina Aguilera, James Blunt is a different matter.
To be honest, I just know you're beautiful. I don't know. I don't actually know how the track goes or how the verses go.
So while Leona waits, the McDonald's have settled on one of their favourite songs.
We just come out there, done a routine, Lone Star Amazed. It's a really, really good song. It's the most confident we've felt about any song we've done so far in the competition. It's just the kind of thing we would sing normally, so dead happy. It's been a very successful day for us.
And so the McDonald's head off home, just as Mr. Cal rings with news. He thinks he's found the perfect song for Leona.
The song has changed again, and I think now it's going to be Sorry Seems to Be the Hardest Word.
Sorry seems to be the hardest word.
Sorry seems to be the hardest word.
I love the fact that Leona has an opinion, but I think she kind of knows what she wants, and as soon as she's comfortable, she's almost unstoppable.
Definitely feel that it's the best choice, and I'm so glad that, you know, three is my lucky number, so I'm glad that it was the third choice and I got this song.
To stay in the competition, the right song choice is vital. So when Louis discovered that James Blunt's Beautiful is now free, he called the boys back into the studio to try it out. But the brothers' concern is Beautiful isn't a song that naturally lends itself to harmony.
If we came into this competition as solo artists, I don't think we would have got here. I think we've got here through our harmonies and just the closeness and the blend.
That's your selling point, you're right.
And I have an idea for harmony anyway. Maestro, first chord.
You go.
Ma la da da da. Da 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 da. And again. Da 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 da. Second chord. Da 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 da. Sometimes there's an advantage to having a theme show like Rod Stewart. You just do all those great Rod Stewart songs. Or ABBA. You do all those great ABBA songs. Well, now it's love songs. Pretty soon, you know, it's going to be Saturday and we're going to do the show. So, you know, love has always been difficult. Not just in music, but in life.
And within time, the boys have found a song and made it their own.
Today has been quite an interesting day from a point of view of changes. Routining can go either way. Sometimes it's very straightforward, and today has not been straightforward at all. You know, it just takes a long time, and we have to get it right. There's no going back. Once you've got it down, the track down, it's very difficult to change it then. So today is the day where things have to be decided, and if it means hanging around all day, that's just the way it's got to be.
Coming up.
Guys, let's go see our Andy. Come on.
I swear, I was expecting this to be worse. It's not even as bad as what they were making out.
It completely blew us all away. We weren't expecting that sort of reaction.
I think finally, we've got the song.
Hello, peeps. It's Saturday night, I was in the bottom two for the second time. My emotions were just really, really, really up and down because at the end of the day, you know, I really didn't want to be there. But it didn't diminish my spirit because I am a fighter. I'm going to get back out there and give it 150 to 200%. I've come this far, and yeah, I'm very grateful for getting this far. But the closer you get, you know what I mean, the more you don't want to go home. I have a dream. I just got to do this, man. I got to do this. You know, just get out there and just shine, brother. Shine on, you crazy diamond.
Back at the house, another day of publicity is about to begin for Ashley. Before he starts today's interviews, he catches up on this week's X Factor news.
I've just seen the headline in the paper. Just basically saying how Simon and Louis are in this big rock about my getting kicked off the show. It's funny, because I just didn't think people would be fighting, not fighting over me, but this is all created around me. It's crazy.
First up, Ash heads off to GMTV.
I'm just about to do my first interview from getting booted off the show at GMTV, so just hope it all goes well.
Helping him out as he takes his place on the nation's most famous sofa is an old X Factor favourite, Brenda.
How are you, love? Your
yeah,
age?
Yeah, I'm good, man. I'm really, really good.
You were very dignified. Mm. You know, there was no tears, there was no kind of like petted lip.
Not at all.
You just said thank you. You were so good, actually.
And that was just a real feeling, you know what I'm saying? Because like, I just felt honoured to be there and it was a great experience, so.
That was all good. So,
right,
sat next to
Brenda.
Say hello.
Oh, hello there. I've adopted Ashley. He's gorgeous and he's coming home with me. Sorry, there's no goodbye to the house. It's mine.
Bye.
Interview over. Ash heads back to the X Factor house. The time has come for Ash to bid farewell to his fellow X Factor housemates. The goodbyes are especially difficult for the remaining 16 to 24s.
I'm going to wake up and he's not going to be there, you know, and all his pictures on the wall come down, and it's just going to be crazy, you know, he's just a big character.
He was really lovely to talk to. If you're upset or anything, he can always give you a helping hand, and he's really good at giving advice. I'm really, really going to miss Ashley.
I can't get to grips of, like, leaving the house, really, because it's like become my home, like it really has become my home. So it's just so crazy, like I can't believe I'm leaving.
I can't believe he's going, I'm absolutely gutted, but you know, he's such a good at what he does. He's not gonna go wrong at all. He's got a massive career ahead of him and we'll be there all the way because he's our mate.
After getting a rough ride from the judges on Saturday, Nikita took the time to watch back her performance to find out why.
Great, that bit was off key. So I was expecting this to be worse. It's not even as bad as what they were making out. There was bits where there was tuning problems, but Sharon made out like, well, all three judges made out like the whole song was out of tune.
You know you had trouble with your pitching tonight, didn't you?
To walk on stage on a Saturday night, you always have in the back of your mind the thousands of viewers that are watching you. And if you do something wrong, it emotionally draws everything out of you.
Harsh comments from the panel tonight, so really, she needs your vote. Okay.
I feel so embarrassed that I'm crying because I shouldn't cry at all. Personally, I think I am a strong person before I came in this competition, and the only thing that this competition is going to do to me is make me stronger. It will not make me weaker in any way, and I have to obviously thank the three judges for that, whether it's bad comments or good comments.
Last Saturday, Louis criticised Ray for doing a swing version of his ABBA song. But Simon is Ray's judge, and he's ignored Louis's complaints, and Ray is, for the third week in a row, sticking to the swing theme.
So swing when you swing, jive, yeah, when you jive, yeah. And then shake when you rock and roll, because the people love when you do that.
Okay. This week I'm still doing swing again, but, you know, it's slightly different. It's got a bit of a Queen bluesy twist to it.
I don't think that there's any harm in Ray doing that, because if you say that Ben's doing a slight rock edge to everything, of course he is, because that's the way his voice is. So it's not fair just to criticise Ray for what Ray does, because they all have a slight style.
I'm just going to go out there, have fun and really enjoy it, and hope that Simon the Mentor like backs me up again like he did last week, because that helped a lot.
Ray is a bundle of joy. Every time you see him, you smile, and I love that about him. And if that means swinging, I think he should swing from the rafters. And I think that he's gonna probably try to do this song so great that Louis can't go after him. I'm gonna feel the way I do. Yeah, yeah!
The Eden Road boys are heading back up north to give us a personalised tour of their home city.
Can't wait!
Welcome to Liverpool, and today we're going to show you around.
First stop, it's David's house.
This is my house. We're going to go raid his room.
Hey, flying the flag.
My very first photo shoot. No.
Look at that fan in his wardrobe.
It's killing me, the raid in the room.
We've got a couple of clothes. This could become a question on ITV2, which cheek belongs to David? Text.
This one. I'm going to joke.
Money! David, don't that kill you?
This is my heart. I can say Eaton Road.
What else have we got? Oh, you just see David and tight.
This is my mum and dad, by the way. This is them. Very far parents.
Word has got around that the Fab Four are back home, and the whole street has turned out to get a glimpse of the local celebrities. Next up, the boys go back to Anthony's school.
Here we are at my school, where I went from the ages of 11 to 16. I got into a lot of trouble while I was here. I was a little terror, but there's so many stories to tell about the school, and if I ever write an autobiography, believe me, the school will be in every chapter, because I love to hear like you wouldn't believe.
Some of Anthony's old teachers come out to meet their famous ex-pupil.
He's absolutely gorgeous. Extremely talented, and we're so proud of him.
Oh, I'm so proud of you. We were laughing. You came into English and you were so upset, and you said, my voice is broken.
But it hasn't broke anymore. Have you heard these notes?
So
it's come back for the truth.
Okay, bye, Anthony. It's lovely to see you too. Okay, bye, Anthony. Give my best to you. Bye.
I just feel a bit emotional actually to see them on, because seriously, it means so much to me, this school.
What What a day! The final stop is the old stomping ground of another famous foursome from Liverpool.
So guys, we're here in Matthew Street and we're about to go and see some of the hot spots where the Beatles used to hang out and perform. So, let's go.
This is the very stage in the Cavern Club where the Beatles started out, and it's just quite it's quite emotional being here actually, isn't it really, just to know that four legends have been and performed on that stage.
So that's it, the magical mystery tour is over. Time for the boys to say goodbye to Liverpool and their adoring fans. Coming up.
Sounds really good. Outside.
I said, look, mate, eventually they will understand.
I feel like I've just lost like a best friend in those.
You've been riding your tractor. You're gonna win the X Factor.
Every week, the Aftermath gives you the chance to win one of the personal effects from the X Factor house.
This week's competition, I'm giving away my pink camera. You can take it everywhere with you. You can put it in your pocket. You can put it in your handbag. You can take lots of pictures of all your friends. It's got a great video on it and it takes really good pictures.
To win Nikita's 7.1 million pixel digital camera, plus this exclusive slimline digital radio straight from the house, and two tickets to next week's live show, all you have to do is tell us. Which ABBA song did Nikita sing on last week's show? A, Dancing Queen, B, Laughing Buddha, or C, Jumping Jack Flash? Ring us with your answer on 0901 293 4040 or text WIN followed by A, B or C to 84383. And most of all, good luck!
Is this yours?
Nokia. Music gets you talking.
Hey guys, just taking the time to talk about our trip to Liverpool this week. It was absolutely amazing to see the reaction that we got when we went back home. You don't realise how many people watch the X Factor until you get back and see how many people are coming up to you asking you for autographs and pictures. It completely blew us all away. We weren't expecting that sort of reaction, and it was making us feel all emotional because we were just loving it. We love the fact that people want to get to know us even more. We were just taken aback by everything. You can't describe the feelings that you got knowing that your hometown's behind you that much. It's amazing. So thanks Liverpool, and we're going to try and stay in for you.
The night has come for the contestants to go and see Mr. Andy Abraham in concert, and everyone was getting dolled up for the occasion.
You know, it's weird to think that last year he was like in the same position as we're in now.
A bit more closer, guys.
As they arrive, Mrs. O meets them, and as usual, the Pats are in hot pursuit.
Come on, guys, let's go see our Andy. Come on. Yeah.
So while our guys watch Andy as he takes to the stage at the Albert Hall, there are two contestants that didn't make the concert. For the past 2 days, neither Louis nor the McDonald's have been comfortable with the song they settled on.
We're in the middle of London when everybody else is going to see Andy Abraham tonight. We're here to try and get a song that's going to show off our harmonies and show us what we are.
That's the breakdown of what the song is. Okay, so.
I think more than for anyone else, it's so important for us to choose the right song for the McDonald's, because their confidence gets bashed every week. Every week they're expecting to get negative comments from Simon, but every week they're just hoping that this is going to be the week where he says, actually, guys, I liked it.
Louis thinks that Robbie Williams' She's the One will be the song that can show off the McDonald's better than anything else. And within minutes, it appears the search is finally over.
I think finally we've got the song. It's the
one. Just a matter of going home now and trying to practice it and stuff, isn't it?
Learn the lyrics, that kind of stuff.
After Andy's gig at the Albert Hall, there's a surprise visit for our housemates.
Hello.
But how's the house changed for Andy?
I can't believe that you guys have got nicer couches than that. I mean, the couches are nice as well. I remember there used to be a little mini gym there as well, where I used to get up like 6 o'clock in the morning just to open up my lungs so that I'm ready for the rest of the day. But the one thing I have to say, you've got a smaller TV. Ours was like 52-inch or something. It's huge.
Being back in the house, and Andy can't resist a visit to his old bedroom. And it was while Andy was here last year that he heard that his mother had passed away.
Does it bring back so much memories?
Yeah, it does, yeah. One particular bad one, though. Yeah.
Does it?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, just to do with the phone call, that, you know. From here. So, yeah, and then I had to shoot off. You know. So, yeah. But it's, I mean, there's some great memories. I had really deep conversations with Chico. The first couple of weeks, he was down. But, you know, I spoke to him and I said, look, mate, eventually they will understand. And in the end, people loved him.
And then it's time for our superstar to leave.
Bye, Andy.
Bye. I wish them all the best for Saturday, the following Saturday, and all the Saturdays after that. I wish them all the best. So yeah, good luck, guys.
It's Wednesday and vocal coach Mark Hudson takes our resident rocker Ben to buy an essential piece of kit for any wannabe rock star, a brand spanking new guitar.
Wow, how many guitars?
Way too many, it's like Christmas.
Well, we're here at Gibson Guitars and we're gonna be picking one out for my friend Ben. Pretty excited?
I'm very excited, Mark. This is a Les Paul Gibson, worth more than me, I think, and more than my life's worth. I'm still dropping. This is a beauty. I've got guitars coming out of my ears.
There it is.
Here she is. We can't see it until Saturday night on the X Factor.
Let's go play in the pub.
Let's go. Yeah, let's go do some busting.
Upstairs, Nikita is rehearsing her song in Ashley's old room, and she starts to reminisce about the best friend who left the house on Monday.
The house is just really empty without him. I feel like I've just lost like a best friend in the house. Because like he was the one I went to like for him to listen to what my song sounded like, and he would give me his opinions and advice. And he's not even here to give me that or to even joke around with. And I just miss him.
Later that night, Nikita gets a call out of the blue. And it's a good luck message from Ashley.
How you feel with your song?
Yeah, I like it.
Good. Well, you know, when you go up there on Saturday, make sure you just rip up the stage so that everyone's proud of you no matter what happens. So, you know, just go up there and let go and just be confident, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We all still love you, baby.
It's just so quiet in this house, I'm not kidding. Yeah. It's like dead.
All right, I love you.
Right, love you, bye.
All right, bye.
It's really nice to know that I've got Ashley, even though he's not here. But he's on the other end of the phone and he's giving me advice and just being there for me.
After a difficult week of rehearsals, the McDonald brothers are putting their all into their song for Saturday. Suddenly, they have an unexpected visitor to the house.
And if there's somebody calling me on, smiling.
Hey!
It's none other than television's Lewis Walsh.
It sounds really good. I'm just outside.
Cool. Yeah.
It's great to hear two people singing a cappella and singing a tune. You very rarely get that now. I think Robbie would even like that version.
Once we heard that, it's amazing. It's a really, really good song. Yeah. So
your voices, guys, your voices are incredible. I picked you for your voices. I always tell you that. Your voices are brilliant. It's been a tough week for you, but you know, you survived.
Yeah, so we'll pull it off.
And you've definitely pulled it off. Mm-hmm. And the best thing about the McDonald's is the harmonies, the voices, you know, it's great. Yeah.
The song suits that. I think the song does
suit
that.
Definitely.
So bring it on, bring it on.
So, as the boys continue to rehearse, it would seem this week the whole house are happy with their song choices. But will they be happy when it comes to facing the judges on Saturday night? Join us again on Friday on ITV2's XS All Areas, where we're behind the scenes with all the contestants as they rehearse for the Saturday show. And round off the perfect week by switching over to us straight after both the ITV1 shows on Saturday night, where we'll have all the immediate reaction from the judges, the losing contestant and celebrity guests. And don't forget to be back here at 8 p.m. next Thursday for more The Xtra Factor The Aftermath, where you can catch all the fallout from the live show and even more exclusive access to life in the house.